U.S. natural gas futures declined on Thursday after the EIA released a slightly bearish storage report showing a larger-than-expected inventory build. Technically, the data was fairly neutral. The 80 billion cubic feet injection was only 4 billion cubic feet above expectations and still 4 billion cubic feet below the 5-year average. However, prices fell sharply following the report, as the U.S. continues to experience warmer-than-normal temperatures, and forecasts for the coming week point to only light to moderate demand. Updated forecasts indicate warmer-than-normal conditions persisting through late October, dampening expectations for early heating demand. Meteorologists suggest that notable cooling is unlikely to develop until the final week of the month. Another key bearish twist is that the market's favorite bullish storyline, the unstoppable rise in U.S. LNG exports, might be running out of steam. To start with, global demand isn't exactly roaring. Concerns over weak energy consumption persist amid escalating U.S.-China trade tensions. Oil and gas prices have slumped as President Trump seems determined to test just how many major economies, from China to India, America can alienate at once. China, for its part, has already stopped buying U.S. LNG and instead keeps welcoming Russian Arctic LNG 2 cargoes with open arms, sanctions and all. By the latest count, around 9 LNG cargoes have quietly arrived in China since late August. Adding insult to injury, Venture Global's recent loss in its billion-dollar arbitration fight with BP delivered a harsh reality check to the U.S. LNG sector, highlighting how fragile that export boom narrative really is. And to top it all off, Europe, despite its tough talk on energy independence, remains Russia's best customer. The EU now buys roughly half of Russia's total LNG exports, and some member states have even stepped up purchases ahead of winter. Russian LNG revenues reportedly climbed 27% in September to 40 million euros per day, with export volumes up nearly 30%. So yes, TTF gas prices are notably lower even though EU storage is sitting at 83% capacity versus 93% last year. Apparently, cheap Russian LNG still beats the expensive Freedom gas coming from across the Atlantic. Overall, only a much colder December forecast could rescue prices from further declines, but traders will have to wait at least 2 more weeks for the first preliminary outlooks to see if winter will finally bring some relief. Price action had been attempting to establish a near-term base around the $3 mark after filling the recent rollover gap, with the market hovering just above this key psychological level. However, today's decisive move below the threshold confirmed additional downside momentum, effectively removing the near-term possibility of a breakout above the $3.25 resistance, and with it, the chance for a tactical rally. Technically, natural gas remains deeply oversold, and a short covering rebound or profit-taking bounce cannot be ruled out, though the $3.25 level still stands as the primary barrier to any sustained upside move. At this stage, only a strong catalyst, such as a markedly colder weather forecast, could offer bullish traders a lifeline. Don't forget to drop a comment, check out the last video and support the channel. Catch you in the next one.